Vihari
Radha Madhav is a Radharani's
Madhava?
Rajini Shakti. Internal potency.
No, that is too much philosophy. Not internal.
Consort.
Consort. Or beloved of Srimati Radharani. Who is this? Jarada Madhav. Madhav. Krishna. Beloved. Kunjabhya. So he's a person who is roaming in the Kunjabhan in the forest. So that is the person. That is the established first line that he's a person, not some air moving around. So Krishna consciousness philosophy is personality. This is one. And that's Gopijana Ballava Girivaradhari. Again, personality. One who give pleasure of the gopis. And one who took the Giridhan, Girivar, Govardhan. You can picturize the whole songs. Eh? We sing often, but we don't picturize. So, you take in the whole Govardhan, that is also person. So, every line, personality involved. Kunjube, Girivaradhari. Yarada Madhava Kunjavari Gopijana Vallava Girivaradhari. Yashoda Nandana, again personality. He's a son of Yashoda Mata. Yashoda Nandana Brajajana Ranjana, and one who gives pleasure of the inhabitants of Vrindavan. Jamuna Tira Vanachari, and one who roaming in the bank of the river of Jamuna. So the whole concept of Krishna consciousness philosophy is a personality, pastime, relation, interaction, activities. That is called Krishna consciousness movement. And we don't find this kind of philosophy in any other organization. You know, they have you know, everything in the air, you know. Everything like a, nobody is there. Beautiful songs but without personality. So this is called Krishna consciousness philosophy. The problem in our Krishna consciousness, like what is our actually problem? What is our problem? Why we cannot understand this? What is our problem? Anybody can answer?
We don't have desire, we don't have faith.
No, that is not a problem. We have desire, we also have faith. That's not a problem.
We are in the mode of ignorance.
No. Mode of ignorance, almost same.
Tamoguna.
It is almost same. So I will bring one story, then we will focus that what is our problem, and answer will come out. Okay? Our problem, first problem in Bhagavad Gita, what is it? First problem that Krishna talks in Bhagavad Gita. What is the first problem? What is the concept in Bhagavad Gita? First concept.
Surrender.
No.
We are not this body.
We are not this body.
Basic knowledge, yes.
So the solution will come, okay? We are not this body. This is the first concept Bhagavad Gita, Krishna speaking to Arjuna. Because Arjuna is very chaos. I don't know to do this, no. Krishna trying to establish what you're crying for. Hey, actually, you're not crying for nothing. Why? Because actually you are not this body. Right? That is the Bhagavad Gita concept. Right? So how to prove that we are not this body? Anybody? Then I'll bring one story. Okay? Then we'll know how it goes. Ready for the story? And if I'm wrong, please correct me. Okay, everybody from India, from here? You are from India, so you know. In India, dhobi, you know, the dhobi, those who go everybody's house, pick up the cloth,
washerman,
we call dhobi, dhobiwala, washerman, he pick up his car, right? And what is his vehicle in those days, not now, 50 years ago, 40 years ago, their vehicle is a donkey, right? They put all the cloth in the back of the donkey, and donkey go all the way to the river, and there is a dhobi guard. Washer guard, you know, all the dhobi together washing their cloth. Although they don't put any soap. Without soap, you know. And then they dry in the sun and pick up the cloth in the evening and then iron the deliver to you next day. Right? That is Dobiji. So, there are many Dobi or Atma, washermen washing their clothes. And all the donkey gone eating grass everywhere. You know, and then they know the time will come, they have to come, put all the donkey's feet, all the donkey has to walk home back. So one time, you know, India there is a monsoon storm, you know, I'm sure anybody from India, because in Bengal we call Kal Boishakhi, Boishakh, month of Boishakh and Jyosh. The big cloud come during the day even, you cannot see your hand, become very dark, and a very powerful storm comes sometimes. In South India also happened this. Punjab, I don't know. But Bengal and South India, those are in coastal area, this kind of storm is very prominent. Okay? I'm sure in Sri Lanka also that. So all the Dobi washing their cloth, and suddenly they saw in the sky huge cloud, very dark cloud. So one Dobi, another Dobi talking each other. He said, brother, we must go home back today. The big storm coming. We should find our donkey. Let's go back because big storm coming. We have to be careful. So, you know, there was a little forest, a bank of the river. And in the forest, the tiger, many animals live, right? So there is one tiger. And tiger listening that what these people are talking. Okay? So, and tiger listening, said, who is this storm? Storm even didn't come. And just by his name, these people are so scared. I thought I am a very powerful person, you know. And people won't see me or they hear my noise, then they run. But this storm even didn't come. And who is this person? I'd like to know. So he said, and who could be king? I am the king. I live in this forest. And he said, other guy dominating? No. Acceptable. I want to challenge him, and with this person, I must challenge him. And this is a tiger mentality, you know. Lion, tiger, they take challenges. So all the Dobi, they're looking for their donkey. You know? Everybody have a stick looking for donkey. You know, some donkey go far, bringing with a beating up. Let's go, let's go. Everybody hurry up, hurry up. But one Dobi man, washerman, could not find his donkey. He's looking for his donkey. Why? Everybody going away, he's leaving behind because he has to find his donkey to put his cloth. So he's going with his stick, looking for a donkey, and entering the jungle, and he saw something sitting there like this, you know? So he thought this is his donkey, so he's very quietly going. He was so mad that he wanted to beat him up like hell, you know, because he could not find, you know, he's so mad. He can't find his donkey. He finally saw his donkey. He go from the behind. Go from behind and he take the stick and wah! You're sitting here, idiot! Ah! Immediately tiger, my God, who is this guy? Tiger thought, my God, this is probably the storm. This is probably the storm. That's why people run away. My God, bear, oh my God. He got so beaten that he's he never in his lifetime ever got a beaten like this, you know? He got such a beaten, so hard. So tiger now don't say nothing. So let's go! So tiger become a donkey. He start walking, you know? And this Dobi are totally illusion. He didn't, he realized my donkey I found is so mad.
And also dark, yes?
Hmm? Also dark, you could not detect properly, which is called illusion.
Was a tiger or donkey?
He don't know. He thought this is my donkey. He was so mad. He beating him up. And when he walks slowly, he be bang! And tiger again. Don't say nothing. Keep walking. And then he put all the cloth on this donkey, which is not donkey, tiger. And all the cloth, Now tiger walking like a donkey. walking, forming his mouth, and he's thinking, man, I make a big mistake in my life. Why I want to challenge this guy? People left, I should have lived quietly. God, my bad karma. So now he's walking. So there was another tiger passing by. And he saw, what happened to my brother? He became a donkey. Then he said, he whispered, hey, my brother, you are not a donkey, you are a tiger. So this tiger said, keep quiet, otherwise you are going to be same condition like me, giving upadesh, giving advice. So this tiger said, God's sake, man, this guy is totally illusion. Let him go what to do. I tried to save him. So he left. Now this donkey walking and thinking, what he said? He said, I'm tired. No, donkey, what he said? He's thinking and walking. So while he was walking on bank of the river, his shadow reflect in the water. So when shadow reflected in the water, he saw his whole body. And you know, this is a natural tendency of the tiger. They, as soon as they see another person, they make noise. He said, oh. As soon as he did that, this dobi wala realized this was another donkey. He said, oh my God, this is the tiger. Oh my God, his life, for a life is run. And then tiger make another noise. And then he put his all the cloth from his hand and he became free. Then he realized, oh, I'm a tiger. I'm not a donkey. And he became free from all anxiety and pain and distress. So this is the condition of all the living entities in this material world. Because we are in fear. Bodily concept of life. This tiger was becoming bodily concept of life. This washerman was the bodily concept of life. Huh? So all the living entity in this world is suffering due to bodily concept of life. Once you were free, you become a tiger and free. Nobody dared to you. It makes sense or no?
So nice. So yes.
So this is the from Bhagavad Gita, first chapter, when Krishna said, we are not this body. So this is the way to we understand, actually we are not this body. We are like a tiger, free from all anxiety in this material world. Our all anxiety and pain and distress coming due to our not faith, not devotion, because we are caught up in the bodily concept of life. Any question, comment? Prabhu?
No, the very well said, you know, through a nice story, the concept of we are not the body and we are the soul. So that's wonderfully said. Thank you.
I think this is, it's got the real identification.
Yeah.
Understand? Because he was thinking, something else, and now he got his, who I am, you know? I'm so and so, yes?
Yeah, when you recognize that I'm a spirit soul, yes. Then you become very powerful. Because you're connected to Krishna right away. You know, one spark of light have no power, but as soon as you're connected to Krishna, you become very powerful. You can see Prabhupada, how powerful personality. Age of 70, what he did, how? He's proven that he was not involved in the concept of life. That's why he could do these things. Anyone! He can do this once he connected with Krishna, 100% person, guarantee. There is no limit because soul have no limit, body got limit. Any other comments and questions?
This also explains because of the bodily concept, we have the fear in mind.
Yeah, that's why everything coming from the body. No,
yeah. Once we lose it and depend on the Lord. Fearlessness automatically comes.
Yeah, those days in sadhu never fear. When dacoit come to the temple, is to come. They don't fear because They say, okay, kill me, I don't care. There are sadhu like that, you know. Dakaiti will be surprised. People are afraid of them, but they don't care. Because sadhu knows this body is temporary, going to go, and then I'll take another. No problem.
So they don't scare, they don't kill them.
Yeah.
So why are they kill them if they don't care? You know, you kill me.
So maybe, Prabhu, this will be a nice entry into the Kirtan. Maybe you mentioned about South India, rain and South India. You also mentioned about a story long time back about how when a group of devotees were doing Kirtan, there was a guy who was giving trouble. So maybe that would be a nice story.
Yeah.
And then we can start the Kirtan. Prabhu is also here until 8 o'clock and then during the Aarti as well. So maybe you can share that with us. Yeah. Hopefully you remember what I'm talking about.
So he wanted to go back to Hyderabad.
Oh, go back to Hyderabad. So, you know, when actually better to be when you are new devotee. You know why? When you are a new devotee, I think new devotee become more sincere and dependent on Krishna more than when you get passing by for many years.
Yes.
But I don't want to make contradiction because people may think, what are you talking about? As you go older, you're supposed to be more thicker. As you boil the milk, it becoming more sweeter and sweeter, becoming condensed and becoming, you know, nice sweet. Should. Sometimes, as we go passing by, we take for granted, and then we miss the whole sweetness. But when you're older, you're very attentive, you know. You're learning. You have become more faith, holy name, more faith of the devotees, guru, everything, because you're newcomers. And you make less offenses also. When you're newcomers, wait. Oh, senior. So when we used to be very young, I remember, we had really, what Prabhupada said? Prabhupada said, Krishna always protect the devotees. Which is true. So we used to have this consciousness very clear. Krishna always take care of the devotees. What a nice consciousness, you know, to have this. So we are very young, like 18, 19 years old. We used to go Harinam every day. After Prasadam, nobody at home in the temples. Harinam, book distribution. So in 70, I'm talking this story, 1978 in Hyderabad. Mostly Western at that time. Only few Indian devotees you can count in the fingers. This whole Hare Krishna movement actually built by the Western Westerners. Indian people used to see us as a very very suspicious way, you know?
All CIA
people. Yeah, maybe CIA agent. Yeah, maybe they're doing charas, ganja, you know, all kind of stuff. Because white people, you know. That's why this movie came, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna movie by Devanand. Jinataman.
They may be spying.
So all kind of story in India. And all kind of story was in America, in the West. But because this is cult. In West, we like a cult, and India, we like a CIA agent. So Prabhupada got hit by everybody, you know. But we had real faith what Prabhupada said. We used to go out every day. So in Hyderabad, there is our temple in Nampally station, right? Channareddy Sweet Store, still it is there, right?
Channareddy, yeah.
Yeah.
Pure gay story.
Yeah.
Prabhupada says.
So in there is one chalk, you know.
Pullareddy.
Pullareddy. So there is one chalk. We used to go every day for Harinam. So I was like 19 years old. And there was another devotee, 18, 19, some Westerner like 19, 20 years, something. So we like six, seven devotees. You know. We even don't know how to break Midanga properly. But we had that very good spirit, you know. So we are chanting. So chanting. And suddenly, one guy, slim, tall, young man, like 25 something, he came. pulling our dhoti, pulling our sikha, doing this, you know, with no way, just having fun. For him it was like a fun, you know. But we can do nothing because we are a devotee, Vaishnava, right? Vaishnava is very humble and not to protest.
There's a test there.
So what to do, this guy going, my sikha, pulling his sikha, pulling the dhoti, come to the mridanga, pushing like this. Such a disturbance, you know. So then one devotee said, Prabhu, let's chant Narasingha prayers, you know, because Narasingha they protect the devotees. So we had a complete prayer. Yes, Narasingha protect the devotees. So we start, Namaste Narasinghaya Praladaladadayine, singing. He could not believe. My whenever I tell this story, my hair grows, stand, you know. I saw one guy from out of nowhere, very tall figure, good-looking man, very built, like a fire. He's crossing the road very fast, coming to us. So we thought, this guy probably ganging up with this guy, going to beat us up or what? So we more, Namaste, very, you know, low.
Intense.
Very intense praying, Narasingha, no, please, Narasingha Dev, save us.
It's not no, one, it's so close.
Now before one, now two guys, you know. So we start singing, Namaste. But it was opposite. This guy came, look at us, and he came, this guy, and bang, one. He hit so hard. You know, did you ever see boxing? Heavyweight champ, the guy fell on the ground right away. This guy fell on the ground like this. And he kicked him. He said, you are disturbing these devotees chanting Krishna's holy name, and you are disturbing rascal in talking his language, you know, Telugu language.
Oh.
Telugu. I didn't understand. So there was one Telugu. You know who was there? This Maharaj, you can ask. He's a Telugu. He's a very short guy. I forgot the name.
Bhakti Vinod? No.
Bhakti Vinod was not. Now he's Swami. Bhakti Vinod was not there, he came later. He's a Prabhupada disciple. He took sannyas.
Oh,
Omiyavilas Swami.
He was here.
You should say the Rajamil told this story. Omiyavilas was there, he's a Brahmachari. He told me what did the guy said. So, then this guy, somehow or other, he make up. Try to stand up, and said, bang, another one. He ran for his life, and he told, Prabhu, don't worry, keep chanting. And then he left, and he left like a wind, you know. He came like a wind, and gone like a wind. And we had really faith, looked like the Narasingha Dev really came to protect us.
Jai.
When you're proud, the gopis are very proud. Because they think Krishna is always with them. Right? They think Krishna always with them. Krishna loves them so much. They're very proud. See, as soon as pride comes, and what happened? Krishna disappeared. And once Krishna disappeared, no juice, no taste. He lose everything because Krishna is a pleasure of all the
pleasure.
He's a reservoir of
pleasure.
Krishna. Without Krishna, there is no pleasure. Even though the devotee living in the ashram or in the movement for 30, 40 years, they must have some pleasure. Otherwise, he cannot be living like this. Believe me. You cannot say, oh Prabhu, someone chanting 40 years for nothing. It cannot be.
She can play.
You cannot chant 40 years, same movie song. Impossible. Can you, Prabhu, 40 years?
No chance.
You must get something, you know. Doesn't matter what level he and she may be, seems to be. Oh, he's not serious, like guy like me, you know. Ajami is never serious, you know. This guy is not, you know. doesn't matter. It must have some taste, otherwise it cannot be 40, 50 years. It must have something. So Krishna is the reservoir of pleasure. So Krishna disappear means, and I give you one practical example. You may have best friend, you know, and he's not a devotee. I'm sure every one of us have this experience. He may be your classmate from the childhood, best friend. But when you become a devotee and you live your devotional life for many years, you go and see this that you like so much, you may stay with him 2-3 hours, then you'll feel, when I want to go back, you don't feel. You lose this taste. Why? Why?
Because you go to higher taste here.
Because there is no Krishna.
Krishna is not there.
No, this side you get high taste and the other side...
No, Krishna, that's
no,
Krishna.
Dealings, Krishna is not there.
Krishna is there.
You lose the taste.
But you may see one devotee just for 1 month become your friend. You can go out with him, whole day you could be with him, laughing, talking, having good time. Is everybody have this experience or no? So this is called Krishna. If Krishna disappear, no pleasure. So similarly, this gopi is very powerful, very, very happy. They think Krishna is so long, then Krishna disappear. As soon as Krishna disappear, what happened? No taste. So they're crying for Krishna. So this is the melody I'm going to sing, okay? And then when they got Krishna, they become happy. And the same melody will come. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare
Rama. Hare Krishna,
Thank you. Namaha
So please, Nachit Vasakyan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare.
Thank you.
Krishna is the cause of all causes? No, no, no. For me, Prabhupada, cause of all causes. Okay? So please raise your hand. Jaya Prabhupada!
Oh,
Singhayo.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.